Welcome to Shruti's online school, where we believe that learning should always be fun. Get your notebook, pen, pencil, eraser ready. Keep your mind focused and let's start learning. Hello everyone. Today we are going to learn about comparison of fractions. Now, comparing fractions means checking and finding out if fraction is bigger or smaller or equal. Now, comparing fractions can be done when these three conditions are there. Very firstly, while comparing fractions, when denominators are same. The second type is when numerators are same, and the last type is when denominators are different. Very firstly, we'll focus on the first subpart, which says when denominators are same. So here we have two examples, 1 over 5 and 3 over 5. So here the whole of 5, the whole is divided into 5 equal parts, out of which one part is shaded. In the fraction 3 over 5, the whole is divided into 5 equal parts, out of which 3 are shaded. So if you compare these two diagrams and the shaded portion, you find out that this 1 over 5 is smaller as compared to 3 over 5. Now here we compare the numerators. Because the denominators are same, 5 and 5, we compare the numerators 1 and 3. So we see that the numerator 3 is bigger than the numerator 1, and hence the fraction 3 over 5 is bigger than 1 over 5. The mouth is opened in front of the bigger fraction. Example 2, we have the fractions 2 over 3 and 3 over 3. So here the whole triangle is divided into 3 equal parts, out of which 2 parts are shaded because it is 2 over 3. In this diagram, the whole triangle is divided into 3 equal parts, out of which 3 parts are shaded because the fraction is 3 over 3. Now the denominators are same, that is 3 and 3. So we compare the numerators. When we compare the numerators 2 and 3, we see that 3 is bigger than 2. And therefore, the fraction 2 over 3 is smaller than 3 over 3. The fraction which has bigger value in front of it, the mouth is open. Now we have another example, two examples. The fractions are 1 over 6 and 3 over 6. I'll just take 3 minutes time and try pause the video and try to solve both these problems, which are really very simple. I hope you all have solved. Now we move further. So 1 over 6, here you can see one whole circle is divided into 6 equal parts, out of which one part is shaded. The other fraction is 3 over 6, here you will see the whole circle is divided into 6 equal parts, out of which 3 parts are shaded. So if you compare the pictures, so you will see that 3 over 6 part is bigger as compared to 1 over 6. And here, as the denominators are same, we compare the numerators 1 and 3. So 3 is bigger than 1, therefore mouth is open in front of 3. And therefore 3 over 6 is bigger than 1 over 6. Now other set of fractions are 5 over 7 and 2 over 7. So here you will see rainbows are drawn. So the whole rainbow is divided into 7 parts. In the first fraction, 5 parts are shaded, whereas in the second fraction, 2 over 7, 2 parts are shaded. If you compare the shaded parts, you will see 5 over 7 is bigger than 2 over 7. So as the denominators are same, 7 and 7, we compare the numerators 5 and 2. 5 is bigger than 2, therefore the fraction 5 over 7 is bigger than 2 over 7. After this, we move on to the next type, where we are comparing fractions when numerators are same. This is another subtotal. Examples 1 over 3 and 1 over 5. If you observe clearly, you can see that 1 over 3 and 1 over 5 have the same numerator 1, whereas the denominators are different. So 1 over 3 means the whole is divided into 3 equal parts, out of which 1 is shaded. 1 over 5 means the whole is divided into 5 equal parts, out of which 1 is shaded. So if you compare both these diagrams, you will see that this you will see that 1 over 3 is bigger as compared to 1 over 5. Is it clear to everyone that 1 over 3 part is slightly bigger than 1 over 5? So in cases where numerators are same, we compare the denominators. Denominators are 3 and 5. 5 is bigger than 3, therefore in front of 5, mouth is opened. But while we compare fractions with same numerator, the fraction with smaller denominator is bigger. So here, the fraction with smaller denominator is 1 over 3. So 1 over 3 is bigger than 1 over 5, as it is clearly stated in the picture also. Now we move on to the second example, 5 over 6 and 5 over 8. Here if you compare both the fractions, you find out that the numerator 5 is common, whereas the denominator 6 and 8 are different. So for 5 over 6, we take a circle. The whole circle is divided into 6 equal parts, out of which 5 are shaded. The other fraction 5 over 8, in that the whole circle is divided into 8 equal parts, out of which 5 are shaded. So now if you compare both the diagrams, if you compare both the pictures, you'll see that 5 over 6 covers a bigger area as compared to 5 over 8. So here again, the numerators are same. So while comparing fractions with same numerators, the fraction with smaller denominator is bigger. So we compare the denominators. When we compare the denominator 6 and 8, we get 8 is bigger than 6. Therefore, in front of 8, mouth is open. But what we have studied is, while comparing fractions with same numerator, the fraction with smaller denominator is bigger, as we can also clearly see in the picture. And therefore, 5 over 6 is bigger than 5 over 8. Now we move on to the next set of comparison, where we compare fractions with different denominator. In this example, you'll see 1 over 2 and 2 over 3. If you compare the numerators 1 and 2, they are different. If you compare the denominators 2 and 3, they are also different. So in such cases, what we do is, first we make the denominators equivalent, which we have learned previously. In my previous video, I have also shown how to convert fractions into equivalent fractions. So whenever we want to compare fractions with different denominator, what we do is we make the denominators equivalent or same, and then compare the fractions. So for making the denominators equivalent or same, what we need to do is we need to take LCM. LCM stands for lowest common multiple. So here the denominators are 2 and 3. So I am trying to find out the LCM. So what I do is I write both the denominators 2 and 3. And now we start finding the LCM. So out of 2 and 3, the smallest even number what we take is 2. So in table of 2, you get 2, 2 ones are 2. But in table of 2, you don't get 3, so you write 3 as it is. Now, 1 is not yet to be divided because you have already got it as 1. Okay. Now, after this, what we do is, we cannot take 2 now because we don't get 3 in the table of 2 because we wrote it here earlier. Now, we move on to the next number, that is 3. In the table of 3, this 1 we copy as it is. In the table of 3, you get 3. 3, how many gives you 3? 3 ones are 3. So once you have got ultimately 1 and 1, so you will stop dividing and we find the LCM. LCM will be the product of these two numbers, that is 2 and 3. So when you multiply 2 by 3, you get it as 6. So now what we need to do is, we need to make the denominators equivalent or same. How we do that is, we make the denominators equivalent or same, and we have to make the denominator as 6 because 6 is the LCM. So now what we do is, we copy these two fractions again with little larger space. 1 upon 2, 2 upon 3. You need to get the LCM as, you have got the LCM as 6, you need to make the denominator 6. So you have to think, 2 multiplied by what will give you 6? 2 multiplied by 3. So if the denominator is multiplied by 3, you need to multiply the numerator also with 3 because they both are siblings. Whatever is given to one sibling, the other sibling also wants the same, just as we used to do in childhood. The other denominator is 3. 3 multiplied by what gives us 6? Yes, 3 multiplied by 2 gives us 6. So similarly, your 2 also will be multiplied by 2. Why? Because they both are siblings. They both want absolutely the same things. Now, 1 multiply 3 gives you 3. 2 multiply 3 gives you 6. 2 multiply 2 gives you 4. And 3 multiply 2 gives you 6. Now, if you look at both the fractions, you will see they have got a common denominator. Or they have got same denominators, 6 and 6. So when we have to compare fractions with same denominator, what we do is we compare the numerators. We compare the numerators.
3 and 4.
4 is bigger. 4 is bigger,
so mouth is open.
And 3 over what 6 I get is smaller than 4 over 6.
I'll write first 3
and
over
hence
6.
We get the smaller 1 as 4 over 6 is smaller than 2 over 3. Now we have another fractions 2 over 3 and 1 over 6 which need to be compared. That is, we need to find out which is the bigger or smaller out of these two. So here you can see the numerators 2 and 1 are absolutely different. And also the denominators 3 and 6 are also different. They are not same. So in this case again, we make the denominators same so that we can easily compare them. And to make the denominators same, we need to take LCM, that is lowest common multiple. Now,
we find the LCM here, 3 and 6. So when I write the smallest even number 2,
in 2 table you never get 3, so you copy 3 as it is. In 2 table you get 6, 2 3's are 6, so you write 3. Then 2 will not go, in 2 table neither of these 3 will go, so I will write here 3. 3 1's are 3 and 3 1's are 3. Once you get these both as 1, you need to stop. So the LCM is the product of these, the product of these two numbers, product of these two numbers. So the LCM is 2 multiply 3 is equal to 6. So you need to make the denominators same. So you will be making the denominators as 6. Let's start solving. So 2 upon 3, comma 1 upon 6 with larger space. Now 3 multiply by what gives us 6? 2's. So 2 multiply 2. And 6 is the LCM, and here we have 6 as it is, so no need to make any changes. 2 multiply 2 gives 4. 3 multiply 2 gives 6. And this one is 1 over 6. Now you can see that the denominators are absolutely same, 6 and 6. So we need to compare the numerators, 4 and 1, out of which 4 is bigger than 1. Therefore, in front of 4, we have opened the mouth, which shows 4 over 6 is bigger than 1 over 6. And therefore, we get 2 over 3 is bigger than 1 over 6. Next example, we have 3 over 4 and 2 over 5. Here, if you compare the numerators 3 and 2, they are totally different. The other denominator 4 and 5, they are also totally different. So what we need to do is, we need to make the denominators same and then compare. So for making the denominator same, we take LCM, that is least common multiple or lowest common multiple. Now, I have written here 4 and 5. If you write the smallest prime number 2, in the table of 2 you get 2 2's are 4. You do not get 5, copy it as it is. Again in the table of 2, 1's are 2. And 5 you don't get, copy as it is. This is 1, we don't have to think about it. Now the next one is 5. It neither goes in the table of 2. Then next we take 3 table, it will not go. Then we go to the next prime number, 5. 1 as it is, copy, 5 1's are 5. Once you have got both as 1 and 1, we find out the LCM. LCM is 2 multiply 2 multiply 5. 2 2's are 4, 4 into 5 is 20. So we make the denominators 20. 3 upon 5, big upon. 2 upon 5, big upon. Upon and over, they both are one and the same things. Now 4 multiply what gives us 20? Yes, 5. And 3 multiply by 5. Because they both are siblings. Whatever we are multiplying 4 with, same thing has to be multiplied with 3 also. 5 multiply 4 gives 20. As they both are siblings, 2 also will be multiplied by 4. 3 multiply 5 gives 15. 4 5's is 20. 2 4's is 8. 5 4's is 20. Now you can see that the denominators are absolutely same, 20 and 20. So then what you need to do is compare the numerators. So when we compare the numerators, 15 and 8, we get that 15 is bigger than 8. Therefore, in front of 15, the mouth is open. Therefore, we say is 15 upon 20 is also bigger than 8 upon 20. And ultimately, we write our original fraction 3 over 4 is bigger than 2 over 5. I hope everyone understood. Thank you.
Hope you enjoyed this lesson. Please like, share and subscribe to Shruti's Online School. Your subscription really matters to me. Don't forget to press on the bell icon to be alerted for new videos. See you in the next lesson. Bye.